Welcome to Gaea. I'm going to show you how easy it is to create procedural terrains that are super realistic in just a few steps. Now, here is the Gaea interface, and this big blank area is the graph where we'll create our nodes. So let's start by creating a mountain primitive. I will right-click and type in mountain and click the node right here, and it's created this node. I can also go to the toolbox here and drag any nodes that I want from here. So this is a basic mountain primitive. Let me change the seed to see what other shapes it gives us. It generates an instant random shape every time you change the seed. Now, this looks cool, but this is a standalone mountain. I would love to have something with a lot more structure. So I'm going to switch from old to alpine just to see what this shape looks like. And that's cool. That's more like a bulky mountain that I had in mind, because I want to create a scene where it feels like I'm on top of a mountain. I think I would love to have even more structure, so I will switch to the strata mode, which is like alpine, but it creates rock uplift at the top. So you have all these beautiful strata that are forced upwards. They're tilting upwards from geological movements. So that is much more closer to what I want. But again, this is still like a standalone shape. I would love for it to just fill the entire landscape. So to do that, I'm going to increase the scale. I think maybe increase the height a little bit as well. And there, now you have this gorgeous mountain that's all rugged on this side and with these beautiful fluvial structures down here from erosion. So that's looking cool, but I think I would love to have even more erosion on this. So to add that kind of detail, I'm going to drag out a line from the mountain node, and I'm going to create an erosion node. It's listed here just because I used it recently, but otherwise you can type in whatever you need. There are more than 100 nodes available for you. So that's erosion 2, and you can see that it's already adding all this beautiful detail. It's creating this river structure down here and here and all kinds of gorgeous things all across the landscape. Now, to appreciate this even better, I'm going to switch from 1K to 2K for our preview. And you can see that the nodes immediately reprocess and we have our terrain rebuilt at a higher resolution, which is one of the best things about procedural design. You can design it any different resolution and then output it at a very high resolution at a later time. So now, let's look at this beauty. And that's looking gorgeous. So I think one addition I would love to have is more sedimentary flows. So we have this effluvial lines here, but I would love to have more soil flowing down. And so to do that, I'm going to go to the erosion properties. I'm going to increase the coarse sediments. And so you can see it's already starting to create like these things here. I think I would love to have more of it. So I'm going to increase the erosion duration. And so the longer the simulation runs, and as such, you get even more detail across the landscape. So here you can see that while we lose a little bit through erosion from the original shape, we now get a lot more soil and other things that's generated from that material that's been eroded away, which is exactly how it works in real life. And so I think this looks pretty cool. I think one more step I would love to add is I would love to have some sort of stratification that's added on top of this. A little bit of rough, rocky stuff that's going on. And so I'm going to drag out a line from erosion and I'm going to add sandstone. So I'm going to type in the shortcut for sandstone, which is SS. You can see there are shortcuts for all the nodes. And so what this will do is add this kind of stratified, crispy detail to our terrain. Now, I don't want it to overpower our entire terrain. So what I'll do is I'll go down to the modifiers and add a mask by height modifier. This lets me choose the altitude range in which this effect should appear. So let me drag this and find a good place. I think I would love to have it be at the lower area. So I'll make it like so. Adjust and just see what's happening. That looks good. I'm going to reduce the fall off a little bit. Drag this up and I'm going to increase the distortion so it's not so evenly layered. So there, now I have even more detail here. Just to make sure I can break up this detail, I'm going to add one more erosion pass to this. I'm going to increase the coarse sediments here as well so we don't lose some of this fluvial detail or the sedimentary flows. And I think our terrain is pretty much ready for prime time. What it needs though is a good texture map, and we can create that easily as well. So I'm going to drag out a line from the last node in the graph, and I'm going to create a texture base. This is a black and white mask through which we will then infuse color. So here we get to choose what kind of details we want to enhance. So I think I would love to accentuate the slope, and I would love to accentuate the peaks. So those are the two I'm going to push for right now. And then I'll then create a satmap node, which is a collection of more than 1,000 real color maps extracted from satellite data, so I can color my terrain easily. So let's see what looks good. I'm going to try a few different things. This one kind of caught my eye. I'd love to adjust the colors a little bit, so I'll just push the bias until I find the right balance. That looks good. So our color map is kind of ready, but you can see it still feels a little bit synthetic. So to make this feel more natural, just like we added erosion to our actual terrain, we're going to add color erosion to our color map. So I will create a color erosion node, and you can see it starts moving the colors just like as if they were minerals flowing across a landscape. I'm going to increase the blend and sediment density, and I think maybe I'll increase the color hold as well. So there, now you can see that our slightly digital or synthetic looking satmap has now been transformed into this beautiful naturalistic fully renderable texture map. And I think that's it. That's all we need to take this terrain. We can now export this and use it in any 3D application that you want.